It is Sunday, February 2, 2020, and I forget the name of it, but it's a special day, 2-2-2020, and backwards it's the same, I believe, so there's a special name, starts with a P. Anyway, okay, Father, thank you for this day. Seriously, Lord, we come to you right now and put you first. I mean, because you're everything, so we come to you right now and ask you, God, for your help and mercy, and you know, we love you and give you all the praise and glory and worship you. You are God alone, Jesus Christ. My Psalms for the second day of the month are, and I'm going to kind of try to keep this short, okay? Seriously. Hopefully, maybe I can do another video later or more. Because I need to get into the Gospels, and I need to get into the Epistles and various other parts of the Bible. I want to start doing possibly a Periscope live something or other. But that might be down the road still. So, thank you, Lord, for your help. Psalm 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Let's go with Psalm 9. Just random. I will praise thee, O Lord, with my whole heart. I will show forth all thy marvelous works. I will be glad and rejoice in thee. I will sing praise to thy name, O thou most high. When mine enemies are turned back, they shall fall and perish at thy presence. For thou hast maintained my right and my cause. You claim this, not just claim it, but just pray it. It's just let it be a part of your life, okay? God loves his word, and I love his word too. It's powerful. When mine enemies are turned back, they shall fall and perish at thy presence, for thou hast maintained my right and my cause. Thou sattest in the throne, judging right. Thou hast rebuked the heathen. Thou hast destroyed the wicked. Thou hast put out their name forever and ever. The devil is a liar and the father of lies, and he's our number one enemy. Okay, so target the devil first. Because he's all of our enemy, okay? He's the one that comes to steal, kill, and destroy. So we take authority over you, Satan, right now. We bind you. We put you under our feet in the name of Jesus Christ. We thank you, Father God, that you have defeated through Jesus and the cross and the blood of Jesus. You have defeated the enemy, the devil, in Jesus' name. Thank you, Father, for our freedom. O thou enemy, destructions are come to a perpetual end, and thou hast destroyed cities. Their memorial is perished with them. Lord, we lift up Wuhan, China, and this other now area where there's this bird flu. Check out your own, do your own research on news on all of it. We come against this in Jesus' name. There are things, look it up, Google plagues in the Bible, prophecies, okay? But that doesn't mean that this is the big one. It's just like, okay, there's an earthquake in California, is that the big one? Who says there has to be a big one? Okay, who says there has to be a big one? If the church would pray against a lot of this hell, which we're supposed to be praying, first of all, my Father's house is a house of prayer. Never mind, I won't go there today. Bless all the churches, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Bless all the pastors and the churches, their wives, and the husbands of some women pastors. Okay? Wow, you know? Why does it automatically say, oh, bless their wives? Well, maybe there's some pastors that are women. Hello. Okay. Read the book of Galatians. There's neither male nor female. I won't go there. Okay, I won't go there. I'm not going to get in this argument. Satan, you're defeated in Jesus' name. O thou enemy, destructions are come to a perpetual end, and thou hast destroyed cities. Their memorial is perished with them. But the But the Lord shall endure forever. He hath prepared his throne for judgment, and he shall judge the world in righteousness. He shall minister judgment to the people in uprightness. The Lord also will be a refuge for the oppressed, a refuge in times of trouble. Yes, Lord, you're a merciful God, and they that know thy name will put their trust in thee, for thou, Lord, hast not forsaken them that seek thee. We come against communism right now in Jesus' name. Oh, Father, in the name of Jesus. We come against it in the name of Jesus. Set the people free to be able to be Christians in China, to have social media in China. We come against this oppression in the name of Jesus. We pray for their salvation. We pray for your mercy to touch them right now where they're at, being quarantined, Lord. Lord, help them get the food they need. Help them have all the supplies they need. Help them, Lord. Your grace is sufficient, Lord. And they that know thy name will put their trust in thee. Thou, Lord, hast not forsaken them that seek thee. Let them seek thee, Lord. Touch and send your word only to heal, to deliver. Get them the word of God, Lord, in the name of Jesus. I send the word, Lord. I send the word. Father, if I knew how to get on there and convey the word of God to these Chinese people, I would. And so I'm going to seek out how to do that within, you know, U.S. laws. I don't want to break any laws. I don't want to be seen as somebody that's, you know, a traitor to our country. You know, but you know, this is, you know, the Lord said preach the gospel to the whole world. Okay, so Father, you open that door if you want it opened, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Sing praises to the Lord which dwelleth in Zion. Declare among the people his doings. When he maketh inquisition for blood, he remembereth them, but he forgetteth not the cry of the humble. See, he loves these people. He's looking at them, and he's hearing their cry. He's hearing their cry. And we come against financial collapse in America and all over the world. You know, we come against the instability of the stock market. We don't need the stock market to crash, okay? That's people's retirement. Okay, you want to strain on the system? Go ahead and keep hating Wall Street. That's people's retirement. If we have more people with more retirement besides Social Security, people in old age won't have to rely on Social Security. So stop coming against Wall Street. Are you nuts? Are you crazy? I wish I knew how to do Wall Street. But you know what? I won't go there, but I literally run what I do, my so-called business ministry. It's a business ministry because it's not nonprofit. So I literally run it on my own. You know, and I don't want to tell my age, but I put it in there from my Social Security. And I don't want to use those words. But God hasn't set me free to fly financially on my own yet. And some people might go, well, because you're doing it all wrong. Okay, whatever. Whatever. Go ahead and condemn me. Go ahead and condemn me. I don't give a hoot. You better be glad I used that word hoot. Because I'm not perfect. And by golly, I have some old words I would love to drag up, but I'm not going to because I just can't. I can't do that. The Lord says no. No. Okay, so Father, have mercy. You know the Lord loves me. Verse 13 of Psalm 9, have mercy upon me, O Lord. Yes. Consider my trouble which I suffer of them that hate me. Yeah. So-called friends that hate me. Huh, it's okay. I love you anyway, and I forgive you. Thou, and you know, don't try to read into this that if you're a friend of mine and you watch this and you think I'm talking about you, don't even go there. Don't lean to your own understanding. Stop your brain from going there. Cast down imaginations, your own high. Cast down imaginations and every high thing that exalts itself against the knowledge of God. If I say one word and you think I'm saying it because of another reason, that's paranoia. Stop it. Try to be like a child. That's what the Bible says. If you don't become as little children, you won't even enter into the kingdom of heaven, kingdom of God, whatever he says. Okay, so stop being so darn, I'd like to use that other word, darn, but I'll use darn. Okay, stop being so darn paranoid. He says, fear not, fear not, fear not, fear not. You know what? It's serious. He says, fear not. Now, that doesn't mean go out and be rebellious and just do your own thing. Rebelliousness. Let me get back. See why it's good to stay at the word? Have mercy upon me, O Lord. Consider my trouble which I suffer of them that hate me, that thou liftest me up from the gates of hell, death, not hell, well, whatever, that I may show forth all thy praise in the gates of the daughter of Zion. I will rejoice in thy salvation. The heathen are sunk down in the pit that they made. In the net which they hid is their own foot taken. The Lord is known by the judgment which he executeth. The wicked is snared in the works of their own hands. Hegeon, Selah. The wicked shall be turned into hell, and all the nations that forget God. For the needy shall not always be forgotten. The expectation of the poor shall not perish forever. Arise, O Lord, let not man prevail. Let the heathen be judged in thy sight. Put them in fear, O Lord, that the nations may know themselves to be but men, Selah, in Jesus' name, amen. Now, if you go over to the book of Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John, where Jesus came down from heaven, he sits at the right hand of God the Father right now, but he's the Son of God, okay? Now, if I cough, that doesn't mean I have that virus, okay? It means maybe there's dust, or maybe I just need to cough. Okay. So, Lord, I just lift it up to you. Jesus came down, God in man form, the Son of the living God. And how do you think, what, you know, I know some of you go, how do you believe that? I mean, what evidence is there? Well, I was not a Christian. And then I was a Christian. And when I came to the Lord, I had, seemed like I had been through, done, been there and done that. 8 years of full-time college, not very good grades, no degree. So then I started searching at the end of my college, those 8 years, I began searching for truth. I mean, inwardly, I started searching for truth. And you know, people can relate to what I'm saying here. I started looking at Buddhism and Hinduism and blah, blah, blah. I would go to the library and read and never found truth through those things, okay? Then one day, the Lord literally took me into a church. I had, you know, it was a Sunday morning, and I just walked into this church. And this church was full of people. And couldn't tell from the outside of it. And I sat in the back and heard the sermon, and I went down and accepted him into my heart and my life. Just, it was just a supernatural thing. And on the way down, as I was walking, I said to him, you must be who you say you are, the Son of the living God, because I have searched for truth. And I was down at my lowest. I would look out the window of my apartment to a church on the other side of the street. It wasn't the church that I went to that day, but I'm going, is there any love out there? Is there any love out there? And I say that today. I said, is there any love out there? Well, I know what love is, because it's God, and so I don't rely on looking for love in all the wrong places, which I used to do. And that's a whole nother story of why I did that. So anyway, I'll stop here. It's time to wrap this up. You can go to my webpage, newsandprayer.com, and look for Sinner's Prayer, or you can just Google Sinner's Prayer, or just believe in him and say from your heart that Jesus is Lord, because he must be who he says he is. Come into my heart, forgive me for all my sins, and give me that eternal life that you promised, and you will see a difference. And that's what I come back to around that, because when I did that, there was a difference. There was a difference, and it has never changed. Okay? That's why we as Christians can testify that we believe that he is the Son of God, because it's just something it's hard to explain, but it's life. Read the book of John about life. He is life. Okay, he is the light, and he is life, and he's everything that you're looking for. He's everything that you're looking for. If you would just step away from thinking religiously and how, yeah, you know, I understand all that, but real Christians understand what I'm talking about right now. We understand what we're talking about, okay? And so don't get off the Word of God when you get him in your life. Don't start putting religion and church and your pastor and church leaders, not even the worship leaders, don't put them on a pedestal. It's dangerous to put these things that aren't God. These are just tools that the Lord used, just like me. Don't put me on a pedestal. Okay, it's okay to enjoy my videos. Okay, I encourage you to enjoy my videos. But come to the Word of God yourself, okay? Stick with the Word of God yourself and worship him. Not the Bible, not the words, but worship him. And yes, the Word of God is powerful and full of life. And they are his Word. The Word became flesh, if you read in John. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, okay? Genesis, in the beginning, God, okay? It all connects. It's all connected. And through the years, this Bible, praise God, this Holy Bible, which is praise the Lord, it's God manifested. Bye-bye. Have a great day. In Jesus' name, amen. God bless.